Hey guys, I'm back at Grasse Pond. Got Dan with me, and we're gonna hike up there to the 1.8 miles to the Grasse Pond shelter and do a little overnighter, maybe do some fishing. So I don't know if I'll do much from the trail. We're getting a late start, it's about 6 o'clock. You've seen this trail before, so maybe I'll just wait till we get to the shelter to do some video. If we come across anything cool, we'll stop and take a picture. Well guys, we made it. It was about an hour, 7 o'clock. Did pretty good. Dan will be sleeping in the shelter tonight. Brought a bedroll. I think I'm gonna hang my hammock between that big tree right there and maybe that tree there if I can reach it. If not, I'll go back that way. Grasse Pond is down yonder. We'll get a little fire going here shortly. Spot Gen 3 sending the message home that we're safe. With my pack, the ULA Ohm. Dan, what's your pack called again?
It's a Gorilla Pack.
Gorilla Pack. Is it, got a model?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, there it is right there on the side. A Salto 2.0. Dan's got his fishing pole. If we get lucky, we might go down there and see what we got for fish. But right now, we're going to grab a little snack and then we'll get prepared for the evening and then probably cook up some. Got a couple of mountain houses. I forget what they are, but I'll show those later. Hey guys, I got my hammock set up. That is the Warbonnet Blackbird. I am in porch mode. A little crooked porch mode, but it's porch mode nonetheless. Got my snake skins from Mountain Goat. Dutch continuous ridgeline kit with the edge tarp from Warbonnet. Underneath, we've got the Arrowhead Express New River 3-season quilt. And inside is my Owyhee short 3-season top quilt. So, got a little bit of firewood gathered. We're gonna fire up some dinner here shortly. Okay, I've got my do-it-yourself fancy feast stove going there. With my Tokes 850 pot, got 2 cups of water on the boil, because we're gonna, I'm gonna have a Mountain House chicken stew, and Dan's got, what is it, beef and?
Beef and potatoes.
Beef and potatoes over there. Okay, the chicken stew's been sitting in my homemade cozy that I learned off Demeter's video. I'm going to hand the camera over to Dan, see if he can't get me open this, because I don't think I can do it with 2 hands. Kind of dark, too, probably. Let's swing around here. Ooh, that's piping hot. Piping hot. There's a lot of food in here. A lot of food in here. Let me get my... get a little taste. Not bad. Not bad.
Dan, make fire. Good.
Good fire.
Yes. Fire. Fire. Good. Autofocus bad. Oh, it is not like this.
There we go. A little supplemental lighting on the fire. Bullfrog in the background. Sun is setting, set actually a little while ago. Off in that direction over the pond. Don't forget when you're out in the woods to look up. Can't see any stars right now. It's kind of overcast, but maybe a little bit later.
Good morning, guys. It's 6:39. And we got some course going this morning.
And I walked down to the pond to see if I could see whatever that was making that noise. But I'm gonna stop now, it must have heard me. Grass pond. Heavy dew on all the plants. I got a little wet coming down here. Have to walk down that little trail there. You can see it. Middle of the screen going up in the distance. That's the trail. It's pretty swampy in there, so you can't go any further. The trail continues. I think you end up down there. You come around this way, deeper into the woods, and come out at the other end of the lake pond. Now that thing's moved back over there. Maybe a bird. I've never heard that before. Dan's still sleeping. You might hear him snoring in the background there. I'm not sure if it picks it up or not. Sit back up. Got a little tour of the Adirondack privy or outhouse. So far, I get the stick wedge down there to hold the door shut.
It's inside. I won't show you down the hole.
I'll head up the trail here and see if it's up the trail.
Trail continues. There's the lean-to where we're at. You can kind of see my hammock is right there. Dan's in that lean-to. I mean, that is the way we came from. And this is the way the trail goes.
And a little ways down the trail past the lean-to, and it gets pretty overgrown back here. I'm guessing people that do come to the on this hike only go to the shelter. And this is definitely less travel than the other, than the path before the shelter. I'm gonna try to speak up. I think I naturally try to talk quiet when I'm in the woods, but oh, here we go. A little look at the part of the pond. Massive pine tree there that broke off. There's the top of it in the distance there. I've noticed, especially at that waterfall video, that I don't talk loud enough. So I'm going to try to speak louder. There's the top of the tree. Slept pretty good last night. I think it probably got down in the 50s. I had one of these little accurate thermometers, but it decided to stop working. It shut the shelf off and turned itself off back on. Even though the battery was supposedly still good, so I don't know what's going on. It's cheap at Walmart, so a lot of the reviews on it were 50-50. But it was forecast to get to like 56. But I was pretty warm with my synthetic quilts. Problem with those is that they don't pack down well at all. It took up at least 80% of my pack. The ULA Ohm 2.0. I had very little room inside for my food and my hammock. And I didn't put them in stuff sacks. I just squashed them down in there, and that pack was pretty tight. So I may have to invest in some down quilts at some point if I want to keep doing this. And I think I am, because this actually turned out pretty well. We both did that. Dan and I did that mile 0.8 pretty easy. And we felt good last night. I feel pretty good this morning. He's still asleep, so I decided I'd walk down the trail. Well, the trail got thicker there, so I decided to bail and go back and see if Dan's woke up yet. The pond just kind of petered out. I think it might be a little stream there. The woods was pretty thick, so I didn't go down. Mosquitoes are starting to come out now. So we'll head back to the shelter. Here's a little view of the pond, just from up from the shelter. Bullfrogs are out now. My first attempt at hanging a bear bag, PCT style.
Got a cup of water on for a little apple cider.
Breakfast is on. We got Mountain House biscuits and gravy down in there. And Dan had the scrambled eggs and bacon. Let's take a look at those.
Oh yeah, that came out good, man. That is just right where you want it.
single serving size. That's new, I think, from them. And we're going to sit back and enjoy.
Boy, I tell you what, this stays hot for so long. Well, it ain't terrible. How's that? It's all right?
Yeah. Just like the one we had before.
Oh, yeah.
First one I ever had. Pretty good.
You got your peanut butter on my chocolate.
No, you got your chocolate in my peanut butter.
All right, here's the grassy pond shelter logbook. Goes back to 5/17/2013, where a large black bear was sighted at the pond. Hang up your food and pack out your trash. Saw a turkey, coyote, and many toads. Amazing. Yeah, that's when my mom and I were here last. Cornwall, Ontario. Many people drew in here. May 23rd, 2015. So, July 7th, somebody was here. They didn't realize it, but I had already written over here. 627. So I'm gonna write right at the bottom here. Today is 7/11, correct? Guys, my hair's messed up, but I forgot my baseball hat. But we are all packed up and heading out. It is 10 a.m. Lugged that fishing pole all the way in here. Is it?
Yeah.
Is that Shakespeare?
Yeah, it's an ugly stick.
Ugly stick. Hey guys, we've got just under a mile left to go, or like 0.7 of a mile, and we'll be at the car. We're getting ready to get to the turnoff that goes from the Sheep's Meadow Trail, I think it is, it's the Haysbrook Trail. And there's a turn to go to the Grasse Pond Trail, and that's where we're almost there. Alright, well, it is now 11:15 and we made it. One night in the woods, a little hiking in the books. You still alive back there, Dan?
Yep.
We'll see you later.